Hi everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the minimum size of your elements. So we don't always need to rely on a fixed amount of the size. The size can be varied according to your viewport width and height. So we can only set up a minimum amount of the width and the height in order to accommodate to different dimensions of your viewport. So before I discuss this topic, I need to show you the web page on the right hand side. And I produced this website by using the two files. One is the HTML file and the other is the CSS file. So let me show you the HTML file first. This HTML file has a division which contains a paragraph. And I have another division that contains another paragraph. Same for my third division. Inside this division, I have another paragraph. Okay, in order to produce the colors, I simply set up the background color for my different divisions. So for the first division, I set up the background color to light pink. For the second division, I set up the background color to light green. Finally, for my third division, I set up the background color to light salmon. Then let me go back to the first division, and I go to the first division on my HTML file. For now, the background color has a width according to my viewport size. So when I enlarge the window, I'm able to see that actually all my paragraphs would have a width that is changed according to my viewport size. Okay. So in order to limit the size of my element, I can have an idea now. Okay, you can see that I include a horizontal scroll bar at the bottom. That means when I set up the minimum width of my paragraph to be having 600 pixels, it means that even though my viewport width is not able to completely show the background color together with the paragraph content, there is a scroll bar to help me see the entire content with the minimum width of 600 pixels. So in this case, when I make my window larger than before, the width of my element in this big window isn't changed. I still make use of the entire width of my viewport size right now. So the minimum width only helps me to give the scroll bar when my viewport size is too small. Okay, so the scroll bar is present again. So it is one way of setting up the minimum width. In addition to using the pixels as the unit of my minimum width, I can also try this one called percentage. Okay, you can see that my scroll bar is now longer than before. You can see that the element is very long compared to my previous case of using 600 pixels as my minimum width. So what does it mean by the 250%? It means that the measurement is taken relative to the size of the containing block. The meaning of the containing block is that initially my viewport is only having this amount of width. So 250% is measured according to this current viewport width. So you can see that when I do the scrolling horizontally, I will have an extra amount of 150% of the viewport to be shown. As you can see my scroll bar here. Okay, the scroll bar is having only 40% of my entire viewport width. Okay, so 250% means that the minimum width now becomes 250% of my original viewport width shown by the current window width, okay? In addition to using minimum width, we can also control the minimum height. okay, when I set up the minimum height of the division to be 150 pixels, you can see that there is some empty space after the text is set up. Okay. So this part, there's something that the text is not able to cover. So even though the text already finishes on the third line here, okay, the remaining portion of the background color is still shown to you because I set up the minimum height of the division to be 150 pixels, okay? So the minimum height is still shown to you according to the specification shown here. Then let me go to another paragraph. Okay, now I'm going to set up the maximum width and height of my second paragraph as follows. When I set up the maximum width of my second division to have only 400 pixels, you can see that the content is a bit narrowed by such an attribute value pair. Okay, so the max width is only 400 pixels. So when I make the window larger, the effect is not changed because this size is already the maximum allowed width. Okay. When I set up the maximum height to be only 100 pixels, you can see that the background color is not able to cover the entire paragraph, which ends here. Okay. So that means that I will see the overflow coming from this max height attribute value pair. So we say that the overflow occurs. If you like, you can handle the overflow situation by using the overflow attribute together with the appropriate value for the overflow attribute. Then I'm going to show you the situation when there is some conflict between the minimum width and your given width. Same for your minimum height and your given height. So for now, I go to the third paragraph. So let me set up some width for my current division. Now the width of my element is set as 500 pixels. If I set up something more, what will happen? Let's see. When I set up the minimum width to be 600 pixels, which is larger than my original width, you can see that the minimum width value will win the battle between the original width. You see, there is a scroll bar to help me show more of my portion of the paragraph that was not shown previously. So it seems to me that the minimum width already becomes 600 pixels rather than the original 500 pixels. How about setting up the maximum width together? Let us see. You see, the effect is not changed. The minimum width will still win the battle between the maximum width. So we can have a conclusion shown here. When the minimum width is larger than the width, or the minimum width is larger than the maximum width, in this case, the minimum width will win the battle. So this value will be the winner of this situation, which beats the width and the max width. Okay. So for the height issue, we also have similar conclusion. So let me demonstrate the height issue here. For now, the height is 100 pixels. So you see that there is some little part of my final row of the text that cannot be covered by the background color. Okay. So how about setting up the minimum height and the minimum height? Let me do it now. Now, when I set up the minimum height, you can see that the background color has a larger height than before, okay? So it seems to me that the min height attribute value pair will win the battle against the height attribute value pair. How about setting up the maximum height together? Let us see. You see, the maximum height isn't able to beat the minimum height. So we can have such a conclusion again. When the minimum height is larger than the height, or the minimum height is larger than the maximum height, the minimum height will win the battle. So we have a similar conclusion as the situation of the width condition. Okay. So this video already discusses a lot of topics about the maximum and the minimum conditions of your element dimensions. So we can set up the minimum width, minimum height, maximum width, and the maximum height. If there is some conflict between these values, we will see that the minimum width will win the battle, and also the minimum height will win the battle. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.